Hey guys, welcome to the Piggy Bank podcast, your favorite casual gaming podcast with your casual gaming buds. These here are my casual gaming buds. We've got Connor Elliott looking off into space.
Hi.
There he is. He just shifts
the weakest hello I've ever heard in my life.
Hi.
Hi.
Fucking immediately goes back to deadpan. And we also have Tab and Bothell.
Hey, what's poppin', guys? Phil, now, I gave you the benefit of introducing you first on the Uncharted Drake's Fortune review, but you don't return any type of favor now, do you?
No, I don't.
Fuck it.
I don't take bribes, Tavin. I don't know about you. I don't take bribes.
Okay. I forgot what I was going to say earlier. Tavin, you're being petty right now. Did you guys see the UFC fighter who was making
a kid
cry?
Yeah. Made a little kid cry. Yep.
He made a kid cry? Who is this? What?
Yeah. Some I don't keep up on UFC stuff. It just hit
It was one of the fights last night. So, like, in a previous fight, this kid's dad beat him, and then they did the rematch yesterday. And so during that first fight, the little kid, like, because the guy got knocked out, so the little kid went up because his dad won. He was like, yeah, and he like pretended to be dead, like knocked out.
Oh,
for the other guy. And so in this fight, when this the rematch, he beat his dad and he looked for him in the crowd, and then he went into the same thing that he did.
Deserved.
Fell over.
Deserved.
The kids are crying.
Fuck you, kid.
Your dad lost. What can you say?
Yeah,
you know. This, of course, is the Piggy Bank podcast, or casual gaming podcast. We shoot the shit, talk about video games, play mini games, talk about all kinds of everything video games, you know. You know, you can find us here on YouTube, youtube.com/twopennygame, at twopennygame. Sorry, almost forgot about the at.
The at is important.
That's right. That's right. We're also on twitch.tv/twopennygames. No at on that one.
No at.
It's also the same on TikTok, spelled out, twopennygames. And then on Twitter, you got the number two. Penny Games. You know, like I said earlier, we like to play mini games on this show. Connor, what do you have for us this week? I want to start with you. Hey. I'm just going to throw you right into it.
Throwing me right into it? And right into it.
That's right.
So I have all my classic, I guess that landscape, I think it's called. I'm going
to
call it that.
I think every time we have to correct you and say, we're pretty sure we say it's called Where Am I?
Where am I? You're right. Yeah. You're right. Where am I? Where am I? And we're going to go to a couple of different video game places, and Tavin and Phil are going to have to know what it is. Jeez. Now, I will say, I kind of tried to do ones that might not be too easy. So coming here with a strong mindset. Pay attention to the show document.
Uh-huh. Oh, yes. I forgot.
I've got it pulled up. The people can see it.
I have forgotten about the show doc.
The people can
and
see it.
We're just going to go ahead and we're going to drop the first one. First game, guess where am I?
Oof.
Oh shit!
The deafening silence.
Hold on. Buzz.
Oh, Phil.
That is. It's wrong, but it's God of War 2018.
No, it is not.
Buzz.
Tavin.
Is this Death Stranding?
Good guess, but no.
Ah, fuck! It looks a lot like it.
I'm trying to like look at all the different bits there.
I know. I'm looking at these like little blue bits behind the waterfall and stuff. I'm trying to like
I thought it was. That's the reason I thought it was God of War, because I saw like the blue and I thought this was like the like the mountain, like not mountain, but like the area where you. It's one of the dragon areas.
Okay, gotcha.
You guys can buzz in whatever you want and say it if you have another idea.
Yeah. See, I was thinking Death Stranding just because it looks like one of those early areas that you explore.
Mm-hmm. It has a similar like lighting to it in Death Stranding too.
Yeah, it does. British.
Oof.
Okay, I'm gonna throw out a guess here. I'm gonna like the graphically, it reminds me of Halo. So I'm gonna say Halo Reach.
No.
Okay.
Save us time. It is not Halo.
Okay.
Yeah. See, I wasn't thinking Halo, but I do kind of see the Reach look. See the way the quality
it's
of the
grass
textures
for me. That's what it
the
looks
quality
like
of the textures make me think early PS4, maybe late like PS3
late
360 era,
yeah.
Or it's an open world game of any generation.
Shit, man. Connor, do you have like an extra hint for us, or like
I can after Tavin says?
Tavin, give him another guess. Then it'll be two guesses each. Yeah.
Give me. God, the blue, it's the little blue things to give it like almost like a technological look.
I know. It's like ancient technology.
Yeah. I made sure to do this one because of that reason. Maybe
Connor, give me, is this Assassin's Creed Valhalla?
It is not Assassin's Creed
Valhalla. No way. God damn.
So this is, here's the guess, and anytime one of you thinks you know what it is,
yeah.
Say it. This game came out back in the 2000s.
Okay.
But it has a version of it out right now that is updated. So it's remastered.
It's gotten a remaster.
Okay.
Clarifying question. A remaster for the current generation of consoles?
Yeah, for current gen.
I'm not gonna say.
That would make it so much easier.
After another guess, I'll give you that extra hint.
All right. Fuck, man, this is a tough one. Connor, you did good this week. Usually we get it after like one or two.
I know. Yeah.
Fuck.
Damn. I can't even think remasters right now.
I got nothing, man. I got nothing.
Just think of a remaster and throw it out there.
Is it an open world game?
No.
It's not. Okay.
It's not correct, but I'm gonna say Assassin's Creed 3.
No way. I will say cut it off right now. It is not an Assassin's Creed game either.
Okay.
So what was the thing you asked me, Tavin?
Is it an open world
game?
It's not like levels you're locked off each time you go to a different place, but it's not like
open. Oh, so you're saying they took a page out of the Sonic Frontiers handbook and it's open zone.
Connor, it has a remaster, not a remake.
Yes, remastered.
So it is not developed by Bluepoint.
No, it is not. Okay, those would be remakes.
Good job, Connor.
Oh, so he's saying Demon's Souls is a remake.
It is, yes.
It is.
It is.
So you want to go ahead and give you the guess?
Did I already guess Skyrim? Can I guess Skyrim? You said open-ish zone, so it's not Skyrim.
You get one more, Tavin, because I already asked.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I guessed one.
I've got no fucking idea.
This is the hardest one you've done.
Yeah, by far.
Okay. I bet. Do you want me to give you?
I've got nothing, man. I'm gonna have to take a pass.
Okay. Yeah. Well, so again, anyone can jump in. It is remastered for current gen.
Okay. It's recent. I don't fucking know. So this photo
is not from the remaster though. This is from the original.
I believe it is from the remaster. Yes.
What is from the remaster? The fuck?
Buzz.
Tavin.
Is this Metroid Prime?
The answer is Metroid
Prime.
Oh,
my God. You're absolutely right. Holy
right
shit.
Out of my ass. Pulled it right out of my ass.
Also, Connor, didn't you say late 2000s? That was like a 2004 game.
He said 2000s.
I thought he said 2000s.
I thought
you said late. Sorry. I guess I just made the late happen in my mind.
Okay. Well, that was a...
Damn, dude.
That one was hard.
Yeah.
Maybe not be the last hard one.
Metroid Prime.
It was those blue technology things.
Yeah.
All right, here's the next one coming down to the show, Doc.
It's crazy that the Nintendo Switch is still current gen.
It is.
Buzz.
Phil.
I'm saying Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword.
Dang. Okay. I don't know anything about that game, so I was like, I don't know.
I thought this was some Kirby's Dream Land shit.
No, sir.
Dang, that was quick.
I played the first 40 minutes of Skyward Sword, and I was like...
You did not get here.
This game is...
This is like the first hour and a half. All
right. Yeah, it's a game.
Wrong, by the way. This one's going to be easy. Chuck Duck. Chuck Duck. Coming in now.
Buzz.
Fuck.
Mario Odyssey.
That is Mario Odyssey.
Yeah.
If you guys would
that's New Donk City.
It says New Donk City right there.
Oh, well, a little bit of environmental storytelling right there.
New Donk City. Right to the right here is where you do the jump rope moon. It's fucking tough.
I mean, neither of us needed to read New Donk City. We knew it was new. I knew it off the taxi. I don't know why, honestly, but the taxi is what gave it away.
Honestly, you have the crazy cap in the background, too, you know?
Yeah.
It's where you're trading your purple coins for the new getup.
Yes. Yeah, I see it. Yeah.
Well, I guess we're going right into the next one.
Where's Pauline at? Oh.
Buzz?
Tavin?
Oh shit, this is wrong. Fuck, what is this? I'm gonna guess this is fuck, I'm taking too much time now. My first guess was Fallout New Vegas.
No.
And I knew
I'm gonna buzz.
Phil.
This is Hitman.
No.
Fuck.
Hitman. Buzz.
Tavin?
this is Far Cry 4?
No.
Yeah. I'm gonna buzz. I'm gonna say Far Cry 5.
No, and it is not Far Cry.
Damn. Okay, because my next guess was Far Cry New Dawn or whatever the fuck they called that other spinoff title that nobody played.
Oh, Primal.
No, the other one that happened after.
Yeah. After 4.
Yeah.
Directly after 5, my bad.
Yeah, it was after 5. That was it.
Oh, okay. Let's see, this definitely is not Primal.
No.
What kind of basic-ass shit is this?
That's tough, man. I'm gonna...
Buzz. Tab. Is this Rage 2?
No, it is not.
Oh, fuck. That would have been a pull.
This is such a fucking throwaway answer. I'm gonna say Metal Gear Survive.
No.
That's a no.
Well, I'll go ahead and if you want me to give you guys a hint, or if you got more in the chamber.
Go ahead and hit us with a hint, if Tavin's okay with it.
Yeah, go ahead.
This is from a strategy game.
Ooh, Buzz.
Buzz.
Phil.
This is from Gears Tactics.
No.
Fuck.
Because Connor Buzz, it is from XCOM 2.
It is from XCOM 2.
Yep. Yeah, it is.
Yep. Yes. I see now. Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm. Kind of that.
I didn't get to this. When I played, I didn't finish XCOM 2. I didn't get to this part when I played XCOM 2.
Damn, XCOM 2 looks good. Well, I don't even remember this part. It just looks like an XCOM map.
Yeah.
But damn, XCOM looks good. It's competing with like modern age open world games.
Yeah. If I knew for a fact this wasn't MGS5, I probably would have guessed MGS5.
There's some other.
Nah, I knew it wasn't Metal Gear. If it was Metal Gear, but if it was Metal Gear Survive, I would have guessed Phantom Pain, and that would have queued you up for Survive and would have pissed me off.
Last one right here coming in. Final one. You guys Connor's are tied coming. Up, so anyone can go.
Yep.
Anyone can go. Tavin, you freak. There he goes.
Buzz.
Ooh, Tavin.
What the fuck?
This is, in fact, fuck, I've lost it. Is this L.A. Noire?
No.
Fuck. What is this?
It's too moody to be L.A. Noire.
Could have been a nighttime scene or something.
L.A. Noire, everything looks kind of grainy from everything I've seen of L.A. Noire.
I put like a whole maybe 10 hours in L.A. Noire.
Shit.
And then
man.
I was like, this game's boring.
I don't think I played this game.
Buzz.
Wait, Phil hasn't said something yet.
Fucking God.
I'm gonna throw out. Okay. This is just a random guess. Like, I'm gonna say Crackdown 2.
That is random.
It is not Crackdown 2.
And also, Crackdown 2 doesn't look that good.
Dude, this looks good to you?
I mean, it looks old, but it looks good.
I thought it was like around the same area or the same era.
Crackdown games are ugly as shit.
They are.
Always.
Crackdown 3 looks good.
Well, didn't play good.
Yeah. You could play as Terry Crews, though.
Oh, that's so cool.
Connor, is this Buzz, whatever?
I almost 1,000-pointed that game.
Is this... It's not, but I'm going to say it anyway. Is this Infamous First Light?
First Son and no.
No, you're thinking of Second Son. First Light is the spin-off video game.
First Light is definitely one of the games,
Okay, well, never mind.
I just thought Neon Signs, maybe the Neon character or something.
I don't think I know this game.
I mean, I've got like 4 guesses, but like I don't think any of them are right. So I'm gonna opt for a hint out here, Connor.
Yeah, I'm right there with you.
This is a hard one, and because I'm asking for a hint, you haven't said anything yet, Phil. Do you want to throw anything
out? Okay. I'll just throw out... This isn't right, but the way like the sign is like spelled lucky, it's not luck. It's not like spelled correctly. I'm gonna say like I don't know, Final Fantasy 15. 15. No.
See, I'm with you, Phil. Where the lucky and the star is making me think like that's a hint towards something. But...
Yeah. Some kind of like silly in-world thing.
See, Connor is pulling from a generation of games that he knows better than me. So it's like, fuck, man, what the fuck are these?
Well, I guess I'll go ahead and give you a hint. So, this game has been played by neither of you.
Okay.
Thanks, asshole.
I mean, I already knew that. That's not really a hint.
Yep. But neither of you.
I'm going to opt for another hint. fucking jackass.
Yeah, I got nothing.
Fair enough, fair enough. Other hint? What's the best hint for this? Best way to word it, I should say. It's a game that neither of you have played.
Yeah.
Thanks,
dickhead. It's the setup. They're set up.
I'm about to Google Lucky Star and see what happens.
don't do that. You'll get an answer pretty easily. But it's a game that you haven't played, that despite that, you've heard it be brought up on this podcast before.
Buzz.
Disgusting. Yep.
Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines.
That was what I was going to say.
Well, Tavin, it is Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines.
Is it actually?
Yeah.
Yo, never in a million years. I totally thought Vampire was like fucking medieval times.
Yeah. I straight up would have like I was going to say that, but as a joke, not even like thinking.
This game takes place in 2006. What the fuck?
2004, I believe, actually.
Jesus.
That's actually one of the cool things about it, because it's vampires, but it's
so they live forever. Got you.
Yeah, but it's like it adds to the world building of it, because this has very good writing, this game naturally.
Okay.
It really enhances it. You'll find out one of these days when we play it on the game wheel.
What a stupid way to game end club. This.
That was so dumb. Yeah. I'll give you that win. You can win on that, Tavin. It's fine.
Are you accepting that win, Tavin?
Yes, I'm accepting that win. I'm taking whatever I can get. I'm cheap.
Hey, you know what Diesel says.
Does he say? What does he say, Phil?
If you don't win, it doesn't matter if you win by an inch or a mile. Winning's winning.
The winning's winning. Dominic Toretto. Fucking.
What a cool guy.
And the Furious one, I believe. I believe that's right. He says it, yeah.
All right. I kind of want to close with mine. So Tavin, let's go ahead and hit us with that. I think you said you had a draft pick for
us? I do. I have a draft pick. I believe it was 2 weeks ago, gentlemen, where I did a draft pick of video game villains. And now today, we're switching it over to the good guys. We're doing a draft pick of video game heroes.
All those boys with good guy badges.
All the good boys. All the good boys.
Or good girls.
Or good girls. You know? So... as always, we are going to go off of the wheel, which, of course, I forgot to pull up. So, here we go with the spinning. We're spinning the wheel now to see what's up. Nobody can see it. Well, you gentlemen can see it.
I'm not watching the stream, man.
And it is me. So, I'm going first. And then, as always, I guess we'll go clockwise. So, me, Connor, Phil.
I'm last.
In that order. And then now, so many options. So many options. I'm gonna pull. You know what? I think it's just gonna have to be my personal favorite hero in video games. I think
I know what you're gonna say.
The first one. I don't think you do. I think I know what you think, but you don't think what I'm actually thinking.
I think what I thought.
My first pick. I'm going with the one, the only Commander Shepard.
That was gonna be my first pick.
Yeah.
That's not that. I mean, you're correct. That's not what I thought.
I have a feeling I know what you thought, but that'll be probably second round pick if it's still on the board.
If this person is still there,
Connor, line us up. Who is the best video game hero?
We've seen other draft picks from Connor where he has to pick characters. I have a pretty good idea of what he's gonna say.
I don't think you know what you're talking about.
The protagonist from Rage 2.
No, Tavin. Maya is the other parallel to Commander Shepard, who has saved multiple races in the universe, Master Chief.
Mm. Oh, okay.
Not a bad pick.
Not where I thought you were going. That's a great pick. Yeah.
Me neither. I don't know how to spell Master Chief. There we go.
Two easy words.
My first pick, easy. I mean, it's he's the hero of legend. He's a hero of time, hero of Hyrule.
That's a great pull. That's a great pull. Next. So many. Yeah, I'm just gonna go for the one that I think Phil thought I was going for, and I'm going with one Solid Snake.
That is what you thought. That's what I thought you were going to say.
There it is. Solid Snake.
Granted, I know he's technically not the protagonist of your favorite game of all time, but, you know.
He's not, but he's the closest, you know, don't call him a hero, but he's the hero of the series, I would say. The protagonist of my favorite video game is a villain.
Don't call him. Well, it's ambiguous. Could be a good guy, could be a bad guy.
Not in most of the games that he's in.
Don't, yeah, you know, don't call him a hero, don't call it a comeback, all right? That's
what I'm saying. Connor, what's number two?
Number two, since I know Phil's going to be jumping at the bit to get all the big generic name characters, I'm going to go with Mario.
Ah! How dare you call me generic?
A classic.
Just because that was, in fact, my second round pick doesn't mean that I'm generic.
You see, you're not generic. You just know you're trying to play the game, the pick, I'm playing the as game. Much as possible, so you know that it's logical the next step is Mario. When you obviously. Said Link, it was like, obviously. Okay, you chose Link because he's better.
Of course.
As a character.
Of course.
And then you chose Mario because he's Mario.
Right, yes, Link, right. the incredible character of Link.
Yeah.
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 Phil, play, number two pick.
Twilight Princess player? Did you play Twilight Princess?
I played Twilight Princess.
Dumb it. No, you didn't. I'm dumb.
What?
My second round pick. You know, he's one of those good boys who's good for the sake of being good.
Ah, shit.
Going Sora.
Oh, yeah.
Kingdom Hearts.
<Of course. laughs> I saw it coming. There you go. Number three, round three. Fuck, man. So many good choices. So many good choices. Give me... Not me stalling for time. I'm going to go with the one and only... Yeah, I'm going to do it. Nathan Drake.
Aha, there you go.
That's a good one.
That's a tavern pick. Saves the world three times.
That is a tavern pick, I will say.
Yep.
Times, damn. Was that a lot?
Yeah.
That was what I liked about four. That one of the best parts of it.
He does not save the world in that one. He just survives. He just makes it to the end. Connor.
The worst thing is I had one in my mind. Oh, no. There it is. Cloud Strife.
I knew it. He was on my list.
That's who I thought your first pick was going to be.
Oh, well, I got there eventually.
I was just, in my head, I was debating the quality of hero that is Cloud Strife. But...
Well, what else do you guys know about me other than the fact I love Kingdom Hearts?
Ah, shit. Here we go.
I love Link. I love Legend of Zelda. We're going with the blue blur himself, Sonic the Hedgehog.
I was waiting for him to get brought up just so
That's right.
Just so I could roll my eyes. There we go. All right. See, I was going to... See, Cloud was my next pick. Ooh. And so now I've got to dig in the Duffy and think of heroes, you know?
Mm-hmm, right.
Can I pick a duo? Does that count? Do we think? I'm giving it to the group. It's a duo.
Yeah, if it's an inseparable.
I think because like they are a unit. Like together they are a unit.
Say Ratchet and Clank.
I know that's what you're going to say.
Yeah, it's Ratchet and Clank.
In their own
games,
they split up. They split up. They have their own things.
Not often, though. Not often. Really, only in the last one.
Every single game.
I mean,
it does happen.
Like,
it does. They are two.
But it's to like help each other out. Like they,
you didn't play Crack
in
Time. So they're separated for 70% of that game.
Yeah, and you know, like all the great Ratchet and Clank games, Crack in Time, you don't have the two heroes together for the majority of the game. You know what I'm saying? But the ones that matter, it's a unit. They are together. You know what I mean?
I'll give it to you. I'm not happy about it, but I'll give it to you.
Well, like, if I pick Ratchet, are you going to pick Clank? You know?
Well, no. Because Clank, I can't do anything with Clank by himself.
Exactly.
Than, like,
but,
puzzles.
Like, Ratchet without Clank, there's not as much charm there. You know what I'm saying?
Mm. They bounce off each other. It's true.
I'm going Ratchet and Clank. There we go. Connor, round four. What do you got for us?
I got him. Nathan Drake saved the world three times, but this guy did it five times. Dante. Devil May Cry.
Oh, that's a good one. I like that
it's
one.
A pretty good pick. It's a pretty like good pick. One. It's a pretty, pretty good pick there. All right. I'm gonna go. My next pick. I'm pulling up this little thing here to make sure, like, how do more people feel about this person than not just me, you know?
That's true.
How many people? What do people think about this person I'm thinking of? Like. Okay.
He's reaching for an ambiguous pull, which makes me think why. You know what I'm saying?
All right. You know, this person, they're
Video game heroes.
Troubled past.
Video
past,
game you know? Heroes. I'm gonna go. Video game heroes is the category. I'm just
Tavin. Here's the thing. Out there. You're gonna eat your words when I reveal what this pick is, Tavin.
Okay.
You're gonna eat your words.
Because I think I have a thought of where you're going, but like that's not a hero, so I wouldn't go there. But you know, go ahead.
This person's reputation's on the mend, as we saw at the end of their last adventure.
Okay. Okay.
We're going Kratos.
Yeah. Okay.
From God of War.
I'm okay with that one based off
your words, my friend.
Off of his last adventure. His most recent adventure, I would say, yeah, that is a hero now. All of his work before that? No, absolutely not.
Right. But he's turning it around.
He's turning this franchise around, baby.
And up and all the three of my picks beforehand, fun fact, all of them playable in Smash.
Two of my characters are playable in PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale.
That's very cool.
And now, for my final pick, gentlemen, I should have been thinking about this along the way. I've got it. We're talking about saving the world. We're talking about saving the people. Let's talk about liberating people's souls, you know, stealing the hearts of many a people. And I'm going Joker from Persona 5.
He is a good one.
That's a good one. You know, that was a sneaky one. It was a sneaky one. Not literally and figuratively. Connor, give me your final pick, sir.
You know what? He's a man's man. Right?
Oh God, here we go.
When you need to get a few boulders punched, you know to call.
Oh! All right.
Saving the world by punching boulders is a very good feat in the realistic sense. So I'm going to go with that.
All right. Well, Connor, you kind of set me up for that last one because my final pick is the opposite end of that Resident Evil coin. We're going Leon Kennedy.
Chris Redfield over Leon Kennedy is wild, but I'll take it. You know?
the reason why is he's more in the zeitgeist of characters with the
I would definitely say that Leon Kennedy is more normie.
Definitely, yeah.
See, but Chris hadn't had a game since 6 and people would still make jokes about him online. He's the guy they would go to because they think that boulder punching scene.
But I'm just saying that me as before I even played a Resident Evil game, when I thought Resident Evil, I thought Leon Kennedy.
Yeah, I think optically most people think of like if you're going to name the main character of Resident Evil, I think it's Leon. But
Leon,
even though he's been in just as many games as Chris, you know, except no remakes. I mean, other than the GameCube remake of one, but like, you know, his other adventures. Also, his other adventures aren't looked upon as fondly as Leon's. Even if you talk original games, most people like 2 over 1 anyway.
Mm-hmm. And to be quite honest, I probably should have said Jill Valentine, but
no, that would have been a worse pick. That's definitely not as good.
Oh, okay. Well, I guess I picked right in your guys.
Yeah, you just picked the number 2, I think. You just picked the number 2. But it's a good pick. It's a good pick.
And it's Connor, not a bad pick.
It's a very Connor pick. So, running it down, final draft list picks. Tavin, Taz, Commander Shepard, Solid Snake, Nathan Drake, Ratchet and Clank, and Joker. A lot of mine really kind of rhyme there. So, that's interesting. Connor has... I have them all written down, sir. Thank you, though.
I know. Just in case they need to see it.
Connor has the Master Chief, Mario, Cloud Strife, Dante, Chris Redfield. A good list, Connor. A very Connor list. It's a very Connor list, with the exception of Mario. But, you know, you were scoring for points there, and I respect
He just wanted to scoot me. That's all he wanted to do.
Yeah. And then, Phil, we have Link, Sora, Sonic, Kratos, and Leon Kennedy. And I would say also a very Phil list. I think the weakest pick on that is Kratos when we talk about heroes.
But he's
turning the franchise around. So give it another 10 years. And you know, we'll see. Nah, man, he fucked over the entire Greek world. Like, they're all dead. He ruined everything. You know, he's a bad person.
In the words of I can't remember his character's name, but fucking, I know I can't remember the actor's name either.
Which one?
Life finds a way.
Jeff Goldblum.
Jeff Goldblum. Thank you.
In Jurassic Park.
Before the poop scene.
Finds a way. Very good round of draft picking, gentlemen. Yes, I like that one. That one's one of our better ones.
Easier than the villains one.
What happened?
A lot more heroes that pop. A lot easier than the villains. Video game heroes pop out I think more than the villains usually do.
Oh, I did mention that when I was looking for how people thought about Kratos, Kratos was number 3 out of 20 on that list, by the way.
That's insanity. Yeah. I could name 20 heroes before Kratos, you know. Yeah. What's Connor, weird, you might not I had an easier time with villains than heroes. I don't know why. I just had to really think about it.
Connor might not like the fact that this was how the list went, but the number 19 of 20 was 2B from Nier Automata.
Okay, I'm actually surprised she's on there. That's good.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say that it's too low.
No. I think it's really, because it's like, as far as the qualities of a hero, she's definitely like good.
Mm.
But as far as like his absolute hero, I wouldn't go so far to say that.
I will say all three of our lists very testosterone filled.
Yep.
Well, minus gaming, Sora, man.
Gaming
specifically in the 2000s was just a lot of burly men, just a lot of burly white men that, you know, crouched behind cover. You know, you think of Marcus Fenix, you think of Nathan Drake, you think of
Corvo Atano.
What did you say?
Corvo Atano.
Corvo. Oh, yeah, sure. Everybody's thinking of Corvo.
He hides behind covers. You set the parameter.
I had another one that I had forgotten, and it was on one of our lists, and then he's gone. Oh, the Master Chief.
There you go.
Yeah.
So, well, you don't know if he's white. Well, you've never seen his face.
We do know that he's white from the secret ending of Halo 4.
Oh.
Well, also the hit Paramount TV show Halo.
No, ignore that. That's canceled out.
He had sex.
If you beat Halo 4 with on Legendary, just on Legendary, you see like his eyes.
That's true. Yeah. I forgot about that. Never mind, Tavin.
Good game, that Halo 4. I like it.
Yeah. It was. Yeah.
Not a great campaign, but, you know.
It was pretty good.
Good story, but like...
Good, not great.
Good story, but like the level design was definitely lacking. Yeah. And the, what are they called in that game? Not the Prometheans.
Prometheans, yeah.
Not great. Not great enemy types, no.
See, you know, they wanted to eat Mass Effect shit, but then they added a me in there.
Mm-hmm.
God, Protheans are so fun. I wish I had more time, you know? If I had more time, I would play Mass Effect right now. I say that, but I don't know if you guys have been watching what I've been playing this last week, but it's been Skyrim and Battlefront 2.
You're playing Skyrim?
I'm playing Skyrim right now.
Why are you playing Skyrim?
I don't know. The urge just hit me, and now I'm playing Skyrim. I'm level 3. Like
Star Wars Battlefront 2?
Yeah, man.
The new one.
Yeah, the new one. The one from, you know, a couple 2017? Years ago.
2017. The servers were dead.
They're not dead. They just haven't been updated. Like the updates have just stopped. So they're still there. Plenty of players.
Oh. Connor, more Resident Evil for you, or what have you been doing there?
Well, Resident Evil. I started my Portal 2 playthrough.
I need to do that.
I have not done that.
I left during a puzzle, and then I came back, and I can't remember what to do, so we'll try and
solve that.
Classic.
I might stream some Portal 2 tomorrow. Not tomorrow, Tuesday.
It's a very, very charming game.
I've got us down. We are reviewing that game in 2 weeks.
Sounds doable.
3 weeks?
Wait,
1, 2, 3. 3 weeks.
3 weeks. Yeah, that seems
bad. Oh, it's definitely doable.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Tavin's going to want to get that done sooner rather than later, so he doesn't have
to... Yeah, man, Minecraft and Jedi Survivor on the way. That's what it is. Jedi Survivor previews hit, and so I was like, I'm in the mood for Star Wars, so I loaded up some Battlefront 2.
Yeah.
And I'll say, quality lightsaber fighting in that game. It's quality. Is it great? No, but it's quality.
One last thing, I'll put it in there.
Go ahead.
Deep Rock Galactic was the other game that I'm playing. I'm getting more into that. Okay. It's very, very fun. Okay. You guys have Games Pass. No problems.
I have it installed. So.
Oh, yeah. I don't have time, you know?
Fair enough.
I platinum Power Wash Simulator on the PS4.
Yeah, you don't
do that.
Time.
You did do that.
Wild ending to that game. I posted it on my Twitter. Absolutely ridiculous.
It was
very weird.
It was not clear that you got the platinum on that Twitter video.
Yeah, which is weird because it popped like in that the minute and a half. Show. Yeah, it's weird that it didn't pop there.
That's
but
why
yeah,
like,
it popped.
I think. I was literally like, me and Ash were just in the theater, getting ready to watch the Mario movie, and I popped on my timeline. I was like, did Tavin get the plat?
I did.
It didn't say
number 77. You know?
There you go. Speaking of Power Wash, I have been kind of playing a little bit more Power Wash myself. I did the detached house. Is that what it's called?
I believe that is one of the levels. Yes.
Yep. The one where you have to do the pathways first.
Pathways first.
Yeah. So it's like the driveway, the two things on the side. Oh, of the driveway,
yes. All right. This is the small house that's like blue. Is it blue on it? Like a blue roof?
Maybe
blue something.
I don't remember the colors.
Okay. Well.
I unlocked the shoe house and the skate park.
Yeah, they're gonna start getting. Oh god, the skate park is a time sink. Let me tell you what.
There you go. There you go. And then me and Ash have been playing a game called Kiwi. It's K-E-Y, key, and then we as in like the two of us. I think a game came out 2021. It's a cooperative like little puzzle game. Where you're two little Kiwi birds from New Zealand running a post office.
Phil, didn't you also hit the group chat and say you were running around in Chia?
Yes. Chia as well.
Yeah, talk about
only,
Chia.
Only for like, I played for maybe hour and a half, 2 hours, something like that.
Okay.
Very strange. I'd say the humor. So none of it's in English.
Okay, great.
Yeah, so they speak, I think, French is what they're speaking, just with subtitles. As far as humor goes, the only thing that pops in my head, maybe because the art style mixed with like the humor, it reminds me very much of Psychonauts.
Oh.
Yeah, as far as like some of the jokes and stuff that they're saying.
Interesting.
But as far as gameplay goes, it's very, very strange. Like, some bits are like rhythm game, some of them are like... very open, like you can basically one of the things I did is you can take over animals with like some like soul possessing power or something like that.
Oh wow.
I took over a seagull and shit on some people because that's like the special abilities. You can like drop bird poop on people, and then you could like, I controlled a coconut and then you can like throw it really far, like after disconnecting from the coconut you can like toss it. Very interesting. I'm intrigued to play a little more. But I don't know if it'll do more. But more on Kiwi, I'll say, is a very cute, fun, challenging little cooperative game there. A lot of communication that you need to have there. We're just trying to basically three-star all the levels. Like, you know, think like Angry Birds 3-star. Just like try to get them at the lowest time that you can get. And you can get these all these little cute little costumes and stuff for your Kiwis and little glasses and little hairstyles and stuff. It's really funny. Some of it's weird games. Really bullshit. Yeah. And then speaking of weird games, a game I streamed the last Tuesday was The Murder of Sonic the Hedgehog.
Oh, yeah. Tell me about that. I'm interested in that.
Oh, man. It was super fucking funny. Some of the best Sonic writing in all of the games at all, you know? I'd say... I say it's the best Sonic writing since Frontiers, but Frontiers came out last year.
Last year, yeah.
I think as far as character writing, that still shines through as the best Sonic writing, but this one, as far as comedic writing goes, is the best. It's just super fun and goofy and a great exploration of all these different characters and their relationships. And it's just a typical like murder mystery. Like who is the person that killed Sonic, you know?
And the cherry on top is that bastard gets what he deserves.
But here's the thing, though, Connor. Unfortunately, he's not actually dead. It's a murder game. So, like, it's like one of those things, like, you're on a train, and it's like one of those murder mystery games where one person's that's the little car that says, oh, you're the killer. And you get to kill one person on the train. And there's just, like, a whole bunch of hijinks that ensues because one of the people isn't very socially apt. So they used a poison dart to knock Sonic out.
That's funny.
It's like, oh, was that not cool? Was that not okay? Like, but no, very funny. A lot of different, a surprising number of like, what's the word? Permutations for like dialogue trees and different ways that you can like bring, because you have an inventory, so it's like a mystery game, right? So like you'll pick up clues and stuff, and you can give the wrong clue on purpose for a lot of things, and it's like, oh, really? You thought it was this? What are you stupid? Like,
Phil, that sounds like Ace Attorney.
Very similar to Ace Attorney.
Yeah, yeah. Did you ever play those games?
Oh yeah,
they're fun games. I played them on my phone when I was in high school.
I think I've only played the first Ace Attorney game.
Yeah,
because they released a like a collection in 2019, I think.
Yeah, they did. That might have been the same collection that I had on. No, that wouldn't have been, because I got a collection. I think I only beat the first game as well.
Yeah, I think it was just 1, 2, and 3. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I beat just the first of those three games. It was back before I had swapped to before I had seen the light of PlayStation. I was still playing on Xbox, you know.
Well, I actually, is the new one on Switch? Because I actually think I might get that.
The new Ace Attorney, or I don't know. Like I said, the only one I played is the one back in like 2019.
Yeah, I would assume so.
But no, as far as like collecting clues and stuff, it is pretty Ace Attorney similar in that way.
Mm-hmm.
But no, I honestly think y'all might get a kick out of it. There are a lot of references that are very much like, if you're not familiar with Sonic games, you're not going to get them. So you probably won't find it as funny as I did. But it was just really funny how they took the messy Sonic canon and they actually like had it in here. Like at the end of Sonic 06, one of the characters that's in this game, Blaze, basically she's from another timeline, because like the timeline splits off and this is the good timeline that we're in, and she sacrifices herself to stop the bad timeline. So she literally says, "Yeah, I'm from another dimension. I'm just here for Amy's birthday."
That'd be funny. Sounds like there's clever writing going on there.
Yeah. That's very nice. Very funny. And then I don't know if y'all plan on playing it, but there's like a funny bit at the end where so Eggman, like he's trying to have you all delivered to his lair to like lock you up, and fucking the Eggman is sitting there all depressed because his plan gets foiled, and the fucking Metal Sonic and the little like the girl robot character from Sonic Frontiers have little party hats that say "Congrats, Dad," and so they're all just sad, like because this plan almost worked, but it didn't. So they're all just sitting there depressed. It's so funny. Oh man, what
Sonic
a great game!
Are eaten now after having years.
Unironically, will be on my top 10 this year.
Oh, good,
sick.
Wonder we're gonna be better than Resident Evil 4 or worse than it.
I'd be shocked if it was above Resident Evil 4. But
anyway, let's go ahead and just and wrap it up. Let's hop into my last mini game here. Boys, we all love movies and we all love video games, but man, it wasn't until recently that studios started getting it right with video game movies. So here's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be taking a look at taking bits from the top 50 video game movies ranked on Rotten Tomatoes. But here's the thing. We're only looking at the top 5 and the bottom 5.
Fuck. Okay.
Yeah, that's right. It's going to be really hard. I don't think you'll get the number one answer for the best one. And I also very much doubt that you'll get the number one for the last one.
This is just movies?
Just movies.
Okay.
Video game movies.
Fuck, that's hard.
All right.
Best video game movies.
And it'll be like point values, kind of like how the Metacritic quiz goes. Yeah. So like if you get the number one, that's worth 5 points. If you get the bottom pick, that's going to be worth 5 points. If you get like the fifth worst, it's going to be 1 point. And then if you get the number five on like the best, it's going to be 1 point as well. So.
Okay.
Inversing that way.
I assume this is an updated list?
This is an updated list, yes.
Okay.
That if that's your way of asking, is the Mario movie on here?
Well, it is, but also I assume it favors critic reviews.
Yes, it is the tomato review of Rotten Tomatoes, not audience score.
And the tomato reviews are weird.
Yeah,
they are.
Well, I mean, it's literally just like the percentage of positive to negative reviews. That's how it works.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. So like, a bunch of 7 out of 10s could give you 100%.
Yeah. All right, so looks like...
Oh, I was spinning right here.
Oh, man. Tavin will be going first.
You're looking at it. Okay, great.
Yeah, I was looking at it. That's like right on the middle. That's so close.
It was.
Okay.
All right, Tavin, can you give... we're looking at the top 5 versus the bottom 5.
Yeah, okay. So either the worst video game movie or the best will give me 5 points.
That's correct.
Okay. Can I name the worst video game movie? That's hard.
We'll see.
There's a lot of them that I don't know, you know, mm-hmm. a lot of Silent Hill movies that I don't know what they're called.
Right.
Mm-hmm. The Resident Evil ones are bad, but are they that bad? You know, they yeah. should be. They should be heralded as that bad.
But which one's the worst?
I know. That's the other question is which one got the worst reviews, you know?
Yeah.
I can't even remember.
Anymore. I'll say the worst one on here is a 1%.
Oh, that's not a Resident Evil movie. There's no way. Oh God, 1%? What the mm-hmm. fuck could that even be? What?
I'm not certain this is based on a video game that either of you have played.
Fuck. All right, what's the best one?
That but it is a video game that I know of.
Best one, Rotten Tomatoes score.
I do think the best ones are going to be a lot easier.
Not a lot of options. And I know nothing about how critics reviewed any of these movies, so this is hard. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna pull a pick and say the original Mortal Kombat movie.
The original Mortal Kombat. You're specifically saying the one from 95.
Yeah.
Is not
God
in the
damn.
Top five.
Okay.
That is number right. 10 on the list.
Bang. Okay.
With a 45%.
Wow. Okay. So that changes the dynamic of this. That's 45 at number 10. Okay.
Okay. I got one. I don't know if
this
is
Connor,
good.
Yeah, go ahead and hit me with it.
Is it the old Super Mario Bros. Movie?
You're guessing for worst, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a good
one. No, that's number 22 out of 50.
Oh, it's dead in the middle, Connor.
And
fuck.
That's a 29%.
Oh, okay. Shit.
29%?
Mm-hmm.
Give me, because like nobody like really liked it, but nobody hates it. So I think it has a chance of like getting a lot of 6 out of 10s, a lot of 7 out of 10s, a lot of stuff mm-hmm. like that. Give me Ratchet and Clank.
Well, Tavin, that there.
I don't like how long it's taking him to
yeah,
to
sorry. I'm yeah. So that if that tells you anything, it's not going to be
yeah.
in top 5 or bottom. That's number 28. It is below the original Mario movie, yeah.
What the fuck is wrong with you people? Wow. What the fuck?
Yeah, there's a 21% on Rotten.
That's TV. So weird because that movie's 21%?
21%, yep.
Mm. Dang.
What? Like, I'm not saying it's like a great movie, but no. it's better than that.
Would I rather watch that than the original Mario movie? Yes.
Hmm.
I'm so lost now. All right.
Connor,
on you.
I think I may have gotten one of the sleeper ones. Is it Blood Rain?
Ooh, very close, Connor. That would have been the number 6 on the worst.
Oh.
Yes. Dang,
yes.
Very, very close. Yeah, that's very number close. 45 out of 50.
Okay.
All right, go ahead. Give me
4%. 4%.
Yeah. Fucking hell. Never heard of that before. Give me Doom.
Oh.
Mm. That's not going to be on the top 5 or bottom 5.
Ah, shit on me,
but
dude.
I do want to find it. Doom 2005 is 34 out of 50, and it is a 18%.
Dang.
Oh.
I got another one.
Starring Carl Urban and Dwayne Johnson.
Dude, we are netting nothing on this by the end of this.
Yeah. If y'all can't get any of the close ones, I'm giving Connor 1 point for that Blood Rain, and he's going to win.
What was the highest one we guessed?
Highest one you guessed was...
Was it Super Mario Brothers or Mortal Kombat? Oh, it was Mortal Kombat at number 10.
Yeah. Yes.
With a what percentage?
45.
Okay, I know my next guess.
Yeah, Connor?
Okay. Is it, I don't even know if this is the name of the movie, and I don't even be mixing it up, but is it Max Payne? The Max Payne movie?
Oh, no. That's not going to be on the bottom 5 or top 5.
They made a Max Payne movie?
Yeah, with Mark Wahlberg.
What? Yeah,
where is that?
Yep. I never saw it.
Yeah, it's Max Payne 2008. That's number 39 out of 50. It's a 15%.
Dude, keep Mark Wahlberg away from our video game movies, man.
Cause... Mark Wahlberg and Mila Kunis, Stabbin.
Oh, I didn't know
that. What the fuck? That's weird.
Yep. And Ludacris.
Nice. That makes That's sense. Cool. That makes sense, honestly. I'm not bad at that.
Oh, man. I didn't know he was in that.
Well, if number 10 is Mortal Kombat at 45% or whatever, I'm
96
then,
Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, yeah. I'm then going to go... I am then going to go the Super Mario Brothers movie. Because that's at least... One? Yeah, the new one. Because that's somewhere in the 50s.
Well, buddy.
Yeah?
That's number 6.
Fuck!
On the list, yeah. Mm. Yep. Yep, that is 56 on Rotten Tomatoes.
Yep. What guess was that? Was that 4? Or 3?
That was number 3, I think, for you.
I guess Ratchet, I guess Doom.
Oh, no,
I guess
sorry. No,
Mario,
that,
I guess yeah, not, one other one.
Yeah, so that was number 4. So okay. you guys have one more guess to have, and Connor has 2 more guesses. Oh,
fuck. Okay. I'm going to go with one of the best ones. Is it Sonic 2?
Fuck!
Yep. Sonic the Hedgehog 2 is the number 3 answer, so you get 3 points there.
Okay, fuck, good.
That is a 69% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Acceptable.
What is higher than 69%?
I don't know.
Nothing should be.
Huh?
Nothing should be.
I'll be honest, Super Mario Brothers should be. No, not Sonic 2. Not Sonic 2. I take not that Sonic back. 2. Sonic 2 is better. No. Sonic 2 is better. You can catch our review of the Super Mario Brothers movie live on the channel now, and our review of the Sonic the Hedgehog 2 movie.
Mm-hmm. It's on there.
It's on there.
That was one of
there.
The first ones we did.
Yeah.
This is where it gets hard.
See, yeah. Now you got to think.
Hit me with your last guess here, buddy.
Like, how good did the Tomb Raider movies perform? How good did the Hitman movies perform? I don't think any of the Resident Evils are hitting below 6%. Or 4%, whatever the fuck number 6 was.
Yeah, it was a 4%. You're taking a Blood Rain, yeah.
So I think like shooting up is probably our best option here.
Yeah.
But what the fuck is better than Sonic 2?
You might not agree. I'm gonna be honest, I don't even know if you remember this movie exists.
I've got fucking I'm drawing major blanks right now. Don't even know if it exists. What fucking video game movies have they made? Because I'm thinking of like some animated shit. Give me, is Detective Pikachu on the list?
Tabin, excellent guess. Detective Pikachu is on my list here. It's number 4, so you're going to get 2 points on that one.
Okay.
You got a 68%. The Sonic 2 movie got 69.
Because I know those two were close. I knew they were close.
Okay, yep. The last guess for me, it's I have to put it out there. Final Fantasy Advent Children?
No, sir.
Yeah, no.
Oh, that would have scared
Final
the
Fantasy
shit out of me.
Advent Children, where is that? I do remember seeing it on here.
That's got to be on the lower end.
Yeah, it is on the lower end.
I'm going to guess 30s.
You would be wrong. It's not even on the list. It's not even on the list.
Oh, well.
Huh. It's just not included. Like, that's weird. Like, they just
out
didn't.
Out of 50, yeah.
Because that movie's better than a lot of shit.
Yeah. Is that it? We're done? Yeah, we're done, right?
Yeah, that was the last one. Right. I will say Final Fantasy The Spirits Within is on here, but not Advent Children.
That's so weird.
It's number 11.
That's what?
With a 44%, yeah.
Okay.
Is that's one of these really movies, weird.
Since it's over... Mm-hmm. Is the animated Halo movies?
No, you're thinking of Halo Legends. I know
Halo Legends. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
That was an anthology. So
All right, give us our top fives and bottom
all right.
fives here.
So I'm gonna start with the bottom fives. Bottom fives. We'd have been looking for
if a Resident Evil is on here. I'm gonna be mad.
No. So 46 is Mortal Kombat Annihilation, which was 97, which is the sequel to
the second one.
Yeah. With a 4%. Then we have In the Name of the King, a dungeon siege tale.
okay.
No. Yep. Number 47 with a 4% as well. We have House of the Dead.
Oh.
Number 48 with a 3%.
Yeah.
We have Street Fighter, The Legend of Chun-Li from 2009 on 49 out of 50 with a 3%.
Okay.
And number 50, the biggest stinker on this list with 1%, Alone in the Dark.
Oh my god, I should have known that. I saw that movie, and it was one of the worst movies I've seen in my entire life.
Yep.
Wow.
Alone in the Dark.
So we gotta watch it.
Oh, maybe.
I'm down.
We should do like a we should do a drunk movie picture house or something. You know what I'm talking about?
Hell
like,
yeah, that'd be
like
fun.
Record
that'd
be fun. It because I don't think we're gonna get too many like crazy copyright claims on that.
Yeah, right. All right, so then we're going to number five on the best ones. So we have Sonic the Hedgehog from 2020, number five with 64%.
Wow.
We have Detective Pikachu.
Number four.
Sonic the Hedgehog 2.
Of those three movies, that is the appropriate ranking for those three movies.
All right. Here we go.
Yeah.
Number two, The Angry Birds Movie 2.
That makes sense. That makes no, 73%. People said that movie was okay. People said that movie was okay. I forgot about that. Yeah.
Yep. Dang it.
And number one, which I've never even heard of, but this movie came out 2 years ago. Came out 2021. Werewolves Within.
Huh. Yeah, never heard of that.
Yeah,
I feel like I've heard the game, but I did 80, not know they made a movie.
86% on Rotten Tomatoes.
When did that come out? 2021?
2021, yeah.
I fell into that COVID year. Nobody knew anything. Nobody knew anything.
But yeah, with that, I mean, that's Connor wins.
Connor does win. Got me over with 1 point there. Yeah. Yeah.
Connor wins.
What a weird game to make into a movie.
Why are the critics hating on Mario so much, man? I don't understand.
I don't know, man. I don't know.
It was a fine movie.
It was fun.
Definitely better than Detective Pikachu. Definitely better than the first Sonic the Hedgehog.
Don't know if I agree, but
I think that's where that list stops.
I think I could give you better than those two. I think me personally, I like the Sonic movies better.
Also, why was Ratchet and Clank so low on that list? That was not a bad movie. It was not a bad movie. It was boring as shit, but it wasn't bad.
I think a lot of people think that boring is worse than bad.
I mean, I guess, yeah, sure. But it was well animated. The story beats played out fine. Like, it was all logical. Like, I wasn't sitting there scratching my head. I was just kind of looking at my watch every once in a while.
Yeah, because at least that movie looks good, you know?
It does look good. Mm-hmm. It does look good.
All right, well, that is a piggy bank right there.
Piggy bank.
Good one, a fun one. That was very fun.
I liked that one a lot. That was a strong episode.
It was.
Thank you guys so much for watching, tuning in on this episode of the Piggy Bank. You know, casual gaming, your favorite casual gaming podcast with your casual gaming buds. These have been my casual gaming buds, Connor Elliott and Tavin Bothell. Boys, let's go ahead and say goodbye.
Have a good one.
Drink water.